So welcome back students. So in this lecture we will see that how a Java class is written. So basically Java class is written using the keyword class. So as you can see in the first line here, it is a Java class. A Java class has been defined here. It's a class has been defined, and this is the name of the class that is been defined. So the class has been given the name stack. So we are making a stack. So what is the stack? It is a last in last out data structure, stack. You are all familiar with stack. So stack is an example we can consider for a class where the it will be a data will be a array, suppose an integer array, or and then it will be having operations like push and pop. So let us say that it is a class and stack. So the data associated with the stack is, let us say that items means what is the data that it is going to be there, that is the items. Then we'll say what are the operations associated with this stack. So here you can see a push, then you can see here is a pop, and here is a empty. The is empty, whether the stack is empty or not, that is true and false, that we said that the exam register true, so like that. So here it is a checking a function, is empty, true or false. So it will return true or false. If the stack is empty, that we cannot do some operations like pop operation cannot do. So if the stack is not empty, then only we can do pop operation. So while doing the pop operations, like here there is a pop operation, while doing the pop operation, this is one example. But when you will do your own stack program, no need to just follow the structure. Just understand that how to declare a class. So what is the class? A class is a keyword followed by a object, this name of the class stack. A class can have a data, that is the item. So here the name of the data is the item. The rest of the things we will discuss as the class progress, but understand that there is a data and there is a set of operations performed on this data. Say push is a function. This is what a operation by mean when we say set of this is what we mean. So item, we push a item. This is the you are familiar with function, how to write a function, you are familiar. So push a item, pop. So when we pop, we don't give the item name, but when we push, we give the item name because we don't know our data. But in a stack, pop means definitely the last element to pop. So when we do the pop, we don't have to give the name of the data. But when we want to push, we give the name of the data. So our data is the item. Push operation we are doing, pop operation we are doing, and is empty is a function. So this is how a class is looking like. We have a class keyword and a name of the class. Then we have a data and we have certain set of operations.